This is Spanish 2, sentences 229 through 232. 229. Did she help Paco yesterday? ¿Ayudó ella a Paco ayer? ¿Ayudó ella a Paco ayer? 230. Yes, she helped him yesterday. Sí, ella lo ayudó ayer. Sí, ella lo ayudó ayer. 231. Ask your friend, were you going to help Paco yesterday? ¿Ibas a ayudar tú a Paco ayer? ¿Ibas a ayudar tú a Paco ayer? 232. Yes, I was going to help him yesterday. Sí, yo iba a ayudarlo ayer. Sí, yo iba a ayudarlo ayer. All right, now notice this A right here. That's a personal A. Remember, Spanish is based on family, religion, and speed. Well, in family and religion, respect is really important. So whenever something is done to a person, you need a personal A. So like, I hugged personal A my grandmother. I helped personal A the girls. I watched personal A the boys playing football to show respect. Now, if you're hugging a tree or watching beetles or taking pictures of cats, you don't need a personal A. But anytime something's being done to a person, you need a personal A. If you're confused by that, type in personal A. There's a nice clip. All right. Now, I want you to notice, it says, did she help personally Paco yesterday? But down here, the personally disappeared. It's yes, she, him, helped yesterday. Remember, there's a chant. You don't need a personal A with con, para, de, and you also don't need a personal A with direct object pronouns, lo, la, los, and las. I'm not going to explain that right now, but there is. You can check a clip. When do you not need a personal A? I'll say that again. If you're confused by when you need the personal A and when you don't, check out the clip. When do you not need a personal A? Now, remember, imperfect, that aba ia thing, is the easiest grammar pattern in Spanish. Tener turns into tenía, estar turns into estaba. All the irregular verbs are easy except for two. The only two hard irregular verbs in Spanish that are imperfect are these two. Ser turns into era, ir turns into iba. Ser turns into era, ir turns into iba. So if you're confused where this ibas or iba came from, check out iba. Okay? Notice there are two A's in this sentence. Ibas a ayudar tú a Paco ayer. This one is for future tense. Were you going to? Remember the chant. Have to, add K. Going to, add A. So that one's going to. And this is a personal A. Now, if you'd asked your friend, were you going to help Paco yesterday at 1 o'clock, you'd say, Ibas a ayudar tú a Paco ayer a la una. Now, if you're confused by all the things that the letter A can mean, to, at, personal A, future tense, there's a clip. Just type in the letter A all by itself or just the letter A. Now, notice on 232, it's not yo iba ayudar, it's yo iba a, I was going to help. Now, Mr. Holt, this lo went in front and this lo went after, all right? Remember, mays and tays and lays and los generally go in front of verbs. The only time they go after it, there's a magnet. If it's an infinitive, if you can physically circle the ar, er, ir, the lo goes after. There's no magnet here, so the lo goes in front. If you're confused by that, type in magnet, M-A-G-N-E-T, or pronoun placement. All right, that's Spanish 2, sentences 229 to 232.